たんですか、こんなに慌てて。
えらくちゃん、宇宙船で子供が飛び出してしまった。えらくちゃん、これ大きい、警察で連絡してない。えらくちゃん、
いいですか、子供の嘘の話を信じてやるふりすることは教育上絶対に悪いことなんですよ。
しかしですね、あのトモコちゃんの真剣な顔をね。
いけません。
私は天文台長の志賀です。二人の少年を乗せて飛び去った宇宙船の正体は分かりません。今のところ捜索する方法もありません。
すごいな、誰かいませんか。ここは一体どこだろう。
お姉さんたち誰なの。
あなたたちが来るの待ってたのよ。
Greetings everyone, this is Michael again, and welcome back to my channel here on YouTube. Well guys, continuing to give my thoughts on all the original Japanese versions of the Gamera films. Now of course, this is the Shout Factory release of the film, and this is a single disc with two films on it. You have Gamera versus Giron and Gamera versus Giger. There's the disc itself there, everyone. For a detailed listing of my complete Gamera collection, you can check out the first video, the introduction video in this series, and you'll see what Gamera films I actually own. Well guys, this is just like the last release that was Gamera versus Gauss and Gamera versus Virus. Single disc, two films. Inside is basically modeled after those. Disappointed, as you already know if you've been following these videos, that they put two films on one disc, because I really did like the single collections that they did for the original Gamera film and Gamera versus Barugan. But with that said, guys, I can say that this is the best quality that we have seen this series of films here in the U.S. As a matter of fact, the film looked really good. Pretty doggone decent. There is a some issues with some of the blue screening at the time. There's some artifacting on the actual image. There's some debris on the blue screen images. There's actually some lines going across one of the shots that looks really kind of bad. But other than that, even with that, this is still the best quality that you're probably ever going to see of these films, at least until they come to Blu-ray. And I really don't see it in the near future. But it could happen, I guess. I will say, everyone, that by the time this film came into being, the series had definitely dipped in quality. And it's been a slow decline from the original film to this film. But this film definitely dips in quality as far as money goes. The VFX and the miniature effects are really not too good. And as a matter of fact, guys, I had mentioned the blue screening. The blue screening in this film is really atrocious. I don't like it at all. I did not like it. I mean, it may not have been so bad if the miniature effects were better, because there's one shot where the two little boys are standing in front of a spaceship, and the spaceship looks just like a total toy. No realism to it at all. And plastering these kids in front of a blown up picture of a toy, it just does not look good at all. There's nothing convincing at all. Most of the visual effects, as far as blue screening go, are really subpar. And you can definitely tell that funds were cut short. And as a matter of fact, guys, even in this film, we have the stock footage from other films. Not very much like what was in the last film, but we do have a little bit of stock footage in this film. And I guess this film, there's not really a whole lot I liked in this film, guys. I mean, there's a few things that I liked. There's like, they cut money. And you can tell because this takes place on another planet. And the entire planet set is this one big miniature city that's used throughout the entire film that, you know, for cost saving, that's probably a good idea. So they use this one big set. And I like that set. It just wasn't really very convincing. It just looked like a big toy. But at the same time, I liked the design work on it and the way it looked. And if they had sunk a little bit more money into it, I think that it really would have been a nice looking miniature set, a miniature alien city. But unfortunately, as it stands, guys, it's just okay. The monster, Giron himself, definitely a strange looking monster. I'll give him that. Definitely strange. It looks like a giant Ginsu knife with legs. But, you know, there's some fun moments in the film where he battles Gauss. Yes, I did say Gauss. We have another creature in here called Space Gauss. And as a matter of fact, the entire planet is populated by these Gauss. And Giron is actually like the aliens' trained monster. They keep it under control just to battle the, do I say Gausses? More than one Gauss, so he's there to fight them all and keep them at bay. And Giron is a pretty tough monster. I would say that he might be Gamera's toughest opponent in the series so far. Maybe tied between him and Gauss. But he actually is able to penetrate Gamera's shell with that knife. And there's even a scene where he battles Gauss. So you actually get Giron fighting Gauss and Gamera. So, you know, thinking of that fight, I would have to say that Giron is probably, up to this point, Gamera's toughest opponents because he just beat the hell out of Gauss, like, really simple. And it took Gamera an entire film. But, the fight, I would say the fight is fun between him and Gauss. It's quick, too quick, but it's fun. I enjoyed the fight between them. The fight between Gamera and Giron is much better than the fight between Gamera and Virus in the last movie. So that's kind of fun. So, you know, what probably saved the movie for me is the monster fights. But other than that, you know, this film is my least favorite in the series so far that I've seen. And I was really, you know, had never seen the movie, really kind of disappointed by it, guys. Which basically, you know, as far as the story goes, as flimsy as it is, you know, you have two kids in the lead role again. They get whisked off to this planet by a spaceship that just kind of lands and lures them there. They get in the ship, take off, go to this other planet. And I shit you not, the aliens plan on eating their brains. And they want to eat their brains so they can assimilate themselves on Earth. They want to learn more about Earth. So, you know, if you want to learn about Earth, the thing to do is to kidnap kids that are about 12 years old, and that way you learn everything. You don't kidnap a award-winning scientist or a president or a vice president or somebody high up in the government. You kidnap 12-year-old kids to learn everything you want to know. I don't know about you guys, but when I was 12, I didn't know Jack. I knew Saturday morning cartoons, but, you know, that's it. But no, so, you know, they get up to the planet. And, of course, Gamera is the friend of all children, so he mounts a rescue, goes to the planet. And it takes him a little bit to get there because they're going by ship, so the ship is faster. And, you know, while they're there, they're experiencing the aliens. And the aliens are really just two women. There's not a picture of them on this disc at all, guys. But there's two women on this entire planet. Everybody else has been wiped out. And so they're wanting to relocate to Earth and assimilate themselves into Earth. And basically you see the kids' experiences with these two alien girls who are up to something, but they're not letting the kids know that they're actually evil. Of course, we find out pretty early in the film. And they escape, and basically you have them running around the planet trying to get away from the girls, and you have Gamera arriving, and then the fight scene. So there's not really a whole lot of story here. As a matter of fact, from what I've seen so far, these films seem to basically carry the same plot, where you have Gamera meets the monster he's going to fight, he gets hurt, injured, he's out of the film for a while, he heals, and then he comes back and fights the creature and wins. And that's pretty much how it is in here. I didn't hate the movie, guys, but at the same time, there just wasn't a whole lot to like in this film. And what I will say, though, you know, the kid cast, I wasn't really annoyed by the kids. I know a lot of people watch these films and they say the kids are just terrible, they can't stand it and all this. But I really didn't, I can't hate on the kids, guys. I thought they were okay. Nothing just really annoying. I thought that the Japanese acting kid was much better than the American kid. The American kid just seemed a little bit stiff, like he was just not up to appearing in the film. But what really got me in the film, guys, and being a dad of daughters, is that there's a little girl character in this who's actually the sister of the Japanese kid. And there's a picture here, guys, but it's so small you probably won't be able to see it there. But anyway, you know, she witnesses her brother and his friend getting taken up in this spaceship. And, you know, she goes back home and says, you know, the aliens took my brother and his friend. Someone's got to do something. Are they ever coming back? And this little kid just turned in this performance that just really got me. I just really felt sorry for this little girl because nobody would believe her story. So I just thought, you know, that little girl did a great job in this film. And I've also got to say, guys, that, you know, the mom of the Japanese kid, a very beautiful woman, just beautiful. I found myself just, you know, drawn to her. I thought she was so pretty. That happens to me sometimes, guys. That's the male in me. But anyway, yeah, I thought that she was a very attractive woman, very, very attractive. And I would even say at moments, guys, this film felt like I was watching a Toho film. You know, and this is kind of weird, but when I was a kid and I would watch Gamera and Godzilla, I would always like the Toho cast. They always felt familiar to me. And one of the things I can remember watching Gamera as a kid, it just felt like the Japanese actors just weren't, I mean, I could tell they weren't Toho, but they just seemed so far removed from the genre. So, you know, watching this film now and being a bit older, not that much, but I felt like I was actually watching a Toho film until the visual effects and the monsters showed up. But yeah, guys, I really was impressed by the little girl. I think she was just a lovely little girl that did a great job in this film. And once again, guys, the acting and all that, I thought the acting was really good. I mean, I didn't have any problem with the acting and all that. The main problem I had was the miniaturization of the budget. The fact that the tech and the miniatures weren't convincing at all. Even Gamera at times and the monsters just look so unrealistic that it just kind of takes you out of the picture. And another thing too, guys, there's a scene when Gamera is flying through space. They kind of, if I remember correctly, they have him coming forward towards the camera, then he passes by. And the jets are coming out of the back. And you can actually see part, I believe it's the top of the shell, I'm not quite sure, but part of the shell actually burning. So the flame was actually had caught the prop on fire while it was burning, and they left it in the film. One thing that I will mention though, guys, when this was released on US TVs by AIP, there's a scene in the film where Giron fights Gauss. And the fight, in the fight, you know, Giron, you know, this big lumbering beast jumps up in the air and slices one of Gauss's wings off. And then, you know, when Gauss crashes to the ground, Giron runs over to him and starts just slicing him up in pieces. And that was considered too violent for American TV, so they edited that out. Which is kind of funny because when you watch the scene now, when he's slicing up Gauss, you just see these chunks of flesh. There's no bones, no arteries, no blood, nothing. And I'm thinking, God, that's too violent. But anyway, that was kind of a funny scene that they would actually remove that. But as far as monster violence go, guys, I guess you could say that's pretty violent because, I mean, you actually see Gauss is actually getting his ass chopped up. So that was, and I wasn't expecting it. So that was a good part of the film, guys. Just the monster battles were fun, if not convincing at times, but they were fun. And that's basically that and the acting and everything. I didn't hate the film. But overall, you know, just the quality is so dropped that it was hard to take it serious. It actually seems like sometimes I was thinking I was watching one of the Thunderbird movies. But, you know, just overall, they could have did a much better job than what they did. One thing also that I thought was kind of harsh, guys. I watched the American dub of the film, and in the film, the Japanese kid constantly calls his sister an idiot. And I just thought, man, that probably wouldn't fly today on TV with him calling his sister an idiot all the time, but he just calls his sister idiot, idiot, idiot over and over. And it was just kind of like, leave the little girl alone. She's a little kid. Leave her alone. So, you know, I felt bad when he kept calling the girl an idiot. So, at the end of the day, guys, like I said, I didn't hate the movie. I was very, very disappointed with several aspects of it. But overall, I gotta say that I would have to recommend it just because of the monster battles. The monster battles aren't bad at all. I think they were kind of fun. I understand a lot of people didn't like this one. But I think that Giron is such a unique monster. It'd be interesting to see him updated and brought back to current day Gamera films. But very, very disappointed. My least favorite film in the series. Actually, I don't know. No. I'm not really a fan of Gamera versus Baru Gun, but, you know, it just has such great miniature effects and some really neat ideas that it was probably inches over this one. But this would definitely be my last one in the series so far that I've watched that I enjoyed. But the next one is Gamera versus Giger, and this creature looks like a giant triceratops or something, guys. I don't know. Have never seen it, but will give it a watch. Anyway, that's my thoughts on Gamera versus Giron. Next review, my thoughts are coming up in the next video. And as always, guys, thank you all very, very much for watching.